I'm Patrick Daly and welcome to Interlinks. Interlinks is a programme about globalisation and the effects it has had on Ireland and its relationships with other countries around the world over the last 50 years or so. In each programme, we interview a person from another country or with strong connections to another country to get their unique perspective on globalisation as it has affected them, their country and its relationship with Ireland. There's a little bit of history, a dash of economics, a sprinkling of business and an overlay of personal experience from both me and from my interviewees from around the world. In recent programmes, we've had guests join us from Croatia, Spain, Mexico and the United States. Today, we're coming back across the Atlantic closer to home to another one of our EU partners. We're heading to Warsaw, the capital of Poland, one of the EU's larger and more populous countries. In fact, Poland is the sixth most populous country in the EU after Germany, France, UK, Italy and Spain. After emerging from the communist bloc in the late 80s, early 90s and joining the EU in 2004, just 14 years ago, today Poland is a modern economy with a GDP of over 600 billion euros, putting it in eighth place in the EU. The Polish economy is currently growing very quickly at about 4.6% per annum and unemployment is very low at just 3.4%. Today we will be joined by Ana Sapeta, the founder of the Warsaw-based company Ipolmex. Ipolmex is an international trading company with offices in both Poland and Mexico that deals in the trade of agri-food products such as fruits, vegetables and dairy products from North, Central and South America, and in particular works with some of the largest dairy producers in Europe. Ipolmex is a great example of a new era company taking full advantage of the key drivers of globalisation that we've discussed before to conduct its business. Those are the advances in information and communications technology, the deregulation of international finance and trade, and innovation in transportation technology such as containerisation and air freight. Ana and I met at a food fair in Mexico City earlier this year, and I was struck by her linguistic and cultural alignment with Latin America and her experience and know-how in conducting business in that region. So I'm delighted to be joined on the line from Warsaw by Ana Sapeta. Welcome, Ana, and thank you very much for being here with us today.
Hello, Patrick. Thank you very much for your invitation. It's a pleasure for me.
You're very welcome. You, Ana, you run a business in Warsaw that conducts trade between Poland and Latin America. What kind of services do you provide, and who are your customers, and which sectors do you focus in?
I run two companies. The first one dealing with dairy products, mm-hmm. and fruits and. The dairy products we are launching to the Latin American market, mainly to Colombia, Panama and Mexico. And these products are from Europe, from the producers of Europe. And with regards to the fruits, so the fruits we export from Mexico to Europe and United States. So this is my first company, and the second one we also it is something like a consulting business, yes.
Mm-hmm. So
we help in establishing business relations with companies from Latin America who want to enter to the European market, and also companies, for example, from Poland who wants to enter to the market of there, yes,
mm-hmm.
Mainly in Mexico, because my second company, yes, is established in Mexico. Yep. So, yes, I try to use my experience from Latin America. I lived there quite a lot, so, and have finished my studies, so that's why I try to use this.
Okay, so you have presence in Poland, and you also have an office presence in Mexico City. Is that correct?
Yes, exactly.
Okay.
One office is in Warsaw, and the second office is in Mexico City.
Okay, and how long has the business been in operation, or the two businesses?
My first company, I run it since 15 years. And the second one is a new one, since 3 years it's with the fruits. But in the trade, international trade, I am since 20 years, so I have quite good experience. And especially with these countries from Latin America that are very, very specific, are totally different that The commerce is totally different than in Europe, yes.
I was actually, you and I met at I was telling the listeners in the introduction that you and I met first in Mexico City at a trade fair called Mexico Alimentaria, yeah. which was a food fair. And I was very struck by the fact that you spoke Spanish like a Mexican, and also that you seemed to be very aligned with the culture there. So how is it that you came to speak Spanish in that way, and what's your connection with that part of the world?
I have lived in Latin America since when I was 5 years old.
Okay.
So yes, I lived in Colombia, then in Panama, and then in Mexico when I have finished my school and my studies. And it is because of my parents who were working there. And so I was migrating with them. And I think that actually I have a little Mexican accent that sincerely helped me a lot when I am in Mexico in different parts. It is helpful for me very.
Okay, and you mentioned the differences in the business culture between Latin America and Europe. What are those main differences that you would point out?
Well, I think that it is different, totally different culture. Takes a much long time to know some person, yes. So in Europe, for example, the things happen faster, and there takes a long time, yes. So the response from their part sometimes is few days and sometimes is few weeks. So for them it is normal, for us not.
Yeah, so people.
So you have to be very patient, yes, very patient. And it is also very interesting that even between Colombia, Panama, and Mexico, the people are different. So the people who are working or running his business in Mexico are different than in Colombia, yes? And you have to know how to move and what to say and what not to say in some situations. So it is difficult even for me in some cases.
Yeah, I know Mexico and Colombia are both important destinations for Irish business people. Mexico is our largest trading partner in Latin America, and Colombia is growing quickly. So what are the main differences between the two of them?
Mainly the destination. I mean, to Colombia, for example, they mainly buy agriculture products, yes? For example, in Mexico, they prefer or there are more opportunities in industrial sector.
Okay, so Mexico is a more developed economy, is that right?
Mexico is more developed, exactly, with regard to this.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so let's come back to Europe a little bit. So we talk about Poland and talk about Poland and Ireland maybe. So here in Ireland, there are probably something like 120,000 Polish nationals living and working here in Ireland. So Irish people have become very familiar with Polish people over the last 10 or 15 years or so as friends, colleagues, and even sentimental mm-hmm. partners, you know, people marrying each other, Polish-Irish weddings, quite a lot of them. but we don't know really much about the country of Poland. So just tell us a little bit about the vital statistics of Poland today. How big is it?
Yes.
How many people live there? What are the main regions? What's the weather like?
Yes.
And where is
yes.
it? Where is Poland?
Yes. Only I wanted to correct you that in Ireland there are now 1,050.
150,000.
150,000. Polish.
Okay. So, thanks for the clarification.
So I think that Polish is the second language in Ireland.
Yeah, definitely.
Yes. So, but coming to the topic of Poland, so we are in the central of Europe. With the population about something 38 million, yes, of people. We have, our cities are mostly small or medium size. There are not big cities.
So Warsaw would have, two million, something like that, 2 million or more?
Yes, for example, Warsaw is the biggest, yes, and it's the capital, but it has only 2 million.
Okay.
So it's not much in comparison with another, yes, capitals from another countries. But we are situated in the central of Europe, and it's quite comfortable because we are close to another cities, yes, by plane to Vienna or Berlin, 2 hours, or to London, or by car. We have very good communications, so it's a good point. And what more about Poland? Of course, the majority are Catholic.
Correct.
Yes, similar like in your country. And something about the climate, it's moderate. However, since last years, it has changed. It is more raining than snowing, for example.
Okay.
Winter, yes?
Yeah.
And what's more? Something about our life, because a lot of people ask me how is a life in Poland, in Warsaw. So what I can see, for example, the differences, yes, in comparison with maybe not in other countries in Europe, but for example in Latin America, is that Poland is really safe country.
Okay.
Yes, and of course, life is fast, like today.
So Poland, yeah. Poland is safe today, but Poland, like Ireland, is a country that had a very turbulent history, you know, with wars and invasions and famines and so on. So tell us a little bit about the history of Poland. You know, back in 16th, 17th century, I think it was a very large European power, and then it disappeared. And then re-emerged in 1918, and then you had all the wars and so on. So tell me a little bit about what happened in the past in Poland.
Now this year we are celebrating 100 years of independence. So imagine, the Constitution of Poland, for example, was the second in the world. And in 1795, we disappear from a map of Europe for 123 years.
So the country was split up between Russia, Prussia, and Austria. Is that right?
Yes, exactly. The country it was a movement named as a partition. Yes, and Poland was divided between Russia, Prussia, and Austria. Till today, these differences have very big influence, for example, in the society, yes, mm-hmm. or in the development. The east of Poland, or in comparison with the west, is completely more rural, more agriculture. And the south of Poland are very good in development. And also the way of thinking of people, yes, from the west and from the east also is quite different. But what's more to tell, it's quite important, the big migrations in the late 8th centuries, it started big migrations, emigrations, and deportations, famous deportations to Siberia, for example, yes.
When was this?
Yes, it was in the late 18th centuries.
Okay.
And then, of course, the First World, then the Second World, then we had the communism regime. So this history of what can I say from my point of view, that this history of last 200 years has shaped a significant part of Polish society in very conservative, Catholic, and closed to other nations.
Mm-hmm.
It is changing now, but it will be a process, yes.
Yeah. I guess with the economy growing now very fast, so your economy is growing fast, your unemployment is very low, so perhaps you'll have Polish people returning from the UK, from Ireland, from other places with different ideas and different outlooks. And you might even have people who are not Polish wanting to go to live in Poland. So how do you think Poland will cope with that change?
Yes, Poland has changed a lot, but not only in the, as you have mentioned, not only in the economic aspect, but also in the social aspect, yes? We became now a biggest and attractive market in the Central Europe, so now there are a lot of companies from abroad, yes. But I think that the most important are the way of thinking, yes, of young generation, that people young are open-minded, yes. Mm-hmm. Yes, are more tolerant. More confident, I think that there are more important changes. Yes.
Yeah. And then coming to the communist era, which finished up maybe in the late 80s, early 90s. Now, I know you may be actually too young to remember much of this, but what's your view of what life was like in communist Poland as compared to life since Poland joined the rest of Europe and then joined the EU in 2004?
Yes, I was part of this time abroad, but when I came from time to time. So yes, it was very, very sad period for Poland. What I remember, yes, and of course the shelves in the shops were completely empty. The products were available only for the special cards, yes, for meat, sugar. What's more, and there are a lot of funny situation in the movies that the unemployment was 0%, but there were a lot of people with nothing to do, drinking a coffee. Yes. Mm-hmm. So it was quite funny situation. And what's more, of course, the propaganda. Yes. The TV, radio, newspapers were controlled by the censorship. There was a one shop who was selling foreign products, but you have to pay there in dollars.
Okay.
So, in dollars, like in Cuba, in Cuba now. Yes,
yeah.
Exactly.
Okay. So today then Polish society is more modern, but you still have people who probably are conservative and feel like they'd like to conserve things the way they were. So do you see Polish society today as being unified or divided? What are the main political issues? Do you have many immigrants from outside Poland?
Yes, exactly. I think that Polish society can be divided in three groups, I think, taking into consideration the social, yes, level, political level, and the age level, yes.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so I was asking you. What's society like in Poland today? Is it unified or is it divided? And what are the main political issues in Polish society today?
So, Polish society is divided by generation gap, by class and political differences, in my opinion. The young generation, as I told before, now is open-minded, it's more tolerant. It's driven by success, are more confident and positive thinking, yes, and which is very good and useful today. And the generation, the old generation, completely the opposite, yes, so very, very conservative, restrictive and impatient in everyday life, yes.
Mm-hmm.
It is important to mention that as almost all Poland are Catholic, yes. So the church here in Poland is very, very strong and have very big influence in the society, education, and also in the public policy. And we try to change this, yes, but it is it will take years to do it, yes.
Yeah, it's a process.
Yes, it is not so easy, and yes, it will take a long time.
Okay, and then coming back to the economy, so what are the major economic sectors in Poland, and how do you see Poland's economy developing into the future in the coming years?
The largest components of our economy is business sector, followed by industry and agriculture. Yes, so the business sector is mainly the business services. Here we have IT, the shared services center, research and development, which are concentrated mainly in big cities, and here are mainly in Warsaw, yes, because Warsaw is a more financial city, yes. Taking into consideration the forecast for the following years, it will be similar, so the business sector will be in the first position. In the near future, I think that Poland will still be in a first choice location for centers, yes, for companies, big companies from European market, yes. The second one is the industry, and here we have automotive sector.
Yeah.
It's one of the key branches of Polish economy, and here mainly the production of original equipment manufacturers for Fiat, Opel, or Volkswagen. Yes.
Yeah.
And generally, coal mining, chemicals, textiles, and the last one is agriculture. Yes, who is very, very important and significant sector for Polish economy.
So it seems like a well-balanced economy, that it's got lots of different things, strong in automotive, maybe strong in tech, strong in agriculture. And, it's an economy that seems well-balanced to take advantage of its position in the future.
Yes, but it has changed a little because some years ago, the agriculture, for example, was on the first position, yes? And now is on the third position, yes, but in the first position you have business sector.
Business services, correct. Yeah, like many modern economies, services has become number one, followed by industry, followed by agriculture.
Yes, exactly. However, the agriculture, of course, in Poland is still very important, yes. And we are, for example, the sixth producer in European Union.
Yeah.
So we have strong position, especially in food processing.
Yeah, and indeed, your own business is in the agri-food sector, where you trade in goods, particularly in dairy, but also fruit and vegetables. And I guess that sector, particularly the milk powder producing sector, is quite strong in Ireland. Do you see much potential for beneficial economic links between Ireland and Poland in the future? And if so, in what areas?
Yes, I was looking for a statistic, and I was surprised because Poland is a very big producer of milk, but however, we import a lot of this dairy products from Ireland, yes, from your country, and a lot of cheese, a lot of components for producing another special yogurts or creams, yes, but I think that here between our countries, there is potential in this business sector, yes, especially in IT, and because in Ireland there are very good programmers, yes.
Yeah.
Yes. So in IT and others, maybe shared services and pharmacy.
Exactly.
Yes?
Correct.
Yes. So I think that in these three areas, it will be a potential. Of course, all related with fruit, with food production, food processing. Yes.
Okay.
So I don't know, distribution, production of packages or whatever.
Okay. The Polish people who've come to Ireland, they've, as we said earlier, there's something like 150,000, you said, Polish people living in Ireland, and they've become very much a part of the community, although possibly centred mostly in the big cities here in Dublin, Cork and so on. So what do you think is the perception of Ireland in Poland? How do Polish people think about Ireland? And I guess you must have lots of Polish people who lived here and went home. So why do you think so many have chosen to come to Ireland? What do they? What's the perception in Poland with regard to Ireland today?
First of all, Ireland was the first labour market who has opened his door, yes, for Polish workers. Yes, it was the first country, so we started to go there. And I think that there are, it is not one reason, that there is a couple of things, yes. Of course, the salary, the higher salaries, yes. Mm-hmm. The wonderful healthcare system, the social welfare system in your country, yes. The people, very friendly, kind, helpful, hospitable.
You're making me blush now.
Yes, but it's true. We are amazing with Irish people, really, and very helpful in each situation. And also, what was surprising for me is that a lot of people which come to Poland are talking about work culture, yes, and business environment in your country that is on the very high level, yes, and very good and direct, for example, relations between a boss and an employer, yes. Mm-hmm. Well, we have to still learn a lot from from you in Poland.
Okay. Well, thank you very much for your kind words. So tell me, we all know, most Irish people here will know, you know, famous Polish people. Well, we know Karol Wojtyla, who was Pope John Paul. We know Marie Curie or Maria Sklodowska, I think her Polish name was.
Yeah.
Who are some other famous Polish people, either present or past, that we should know?
Yes, I think that maybe someone contemporary now is Roman Polański.
Okay, yeah.
I like his movies, so film director, producer, writer, actor, and he's best known for example, Rosemary Babies, Chinatown Test, The Pianist, a movie for which he was awarded an Oscar. So I think that it is a quite interesting person.
Yeah. As just before we finish up, maybe you would like to take the opportunity to tell people, listeners, where they can find out more about your business if they want to contact you in relation to any of those opportunities in the food business, your website, email and so on, if you'd like to share.
Yes, of course. My email is www.ipolmex.com. And I think that I mentioned about the fruit and dairy products, but the most important, it's a support which I can offer to the companies, yes, who wants to enter to the Latin American market. And we can prepare some analysis of this market, we are creating a marketing, a promotion strategies, yes. We are looking for clients and so more. So.
Well, that's excellent. And thank you very much. It's been a pleasure talking to you and look forward to talking to you.
Yes, the pleasure was mine. And also, I forgot to mention about the wonderful food.
Okay, tell me.
Yes, which we have in Poland. So not only vodka, for which is famous because it has changed. We have wonderful and very good beer, honey wine, dumplings, which are famous with cheese or meat, of course, duck with apples or mushrooms. So you have to come to.
Yeah, I think I think there will be lots of Irish people already have, and I think there will be more in the future visiting Poland very, very frequently.
Yes.
So many thanks, Anna. It's been a pleasure, and look forward to talking to you again soon. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you to you very much.
Bye-bye. Bye. 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 Bye.